Hi everyone, Dr. Ataya, welcome back. Today's topic is cardiac rhythm monitoring. We're going to talk about some of the different options that we have to monitor your heart rhythm. The whole purpose of cardiac rhythm monitoring is to measure the electrical signals of the heart, and it has several uses. We can see if someone's symptoms, namely palpitations, relate to a change in heart rhythm. We can screen for asymptomatic heart rhythm issues, and we can also assess the efficacies of our treatments. There's different ways, and we're going to get into it. The basis for monitoring is that the heart is a muscle and it has its own electrical system. That electrical system leaves a hallmark which we can measure on the surface. That's called an EKG. And the purpose of monitoring is to record an EKG, or the electrical signal of the heart, over a period of prescribed time. The basis for it, as we mentioned, is that the electrical system of the heart has electricity originating from the top right of the heart and then going down to the bottom. Typically, it's nice and orderly, but people can have abnormal heart rhythms, and that leaves a different EKG signal. By looking at these EKG strips, we're able to make a diagnosis. And we can help sort out whether the abnormalities are normal, abnormal, or if they're dangerous. Most of the monitoring that we do and that we're going to talk about today relates to changes in the heart rhythm, basically what's called arrhythmias, which are abnormal heart rhythms. Let's start with it. So I'm sure most of you are familiar with an EKG. We do those in the clinic all the time. We place sensors or electrodes across the chest and we get 12 views of the heart. We can learn a lot from this, not just the heart rhythm. The cardiologists use this quite a bit too. The ER uses it as well. The downside to an EKG is as wonderful as it is, it only lasts for 10 seconds. So if your symptoms come and go, we're not gonna know what's going on. Some arrhythmias are consistent and stay that way for a period of time. Others are fleeting. So what we end up doing is looking for longer periods of time. If you're in the hospital, we connect you to what's called telemetry. That's basically an EKG that's done over a prolonged period of time. It's connected to a central station, and an EKG monitor or technologist is watching. This provides a lot of valuable information for someone while they're hospitalized, but the downside is it's only there in the hospital. So in order to gather more information, we often send people home with a Holter monitor, a 48-hour Holter monitor. And the nice thing about this is that it is also able to transmit. So someone is watching that heart rhythm as well. It typically connects to a modem where you connect the wires to your chest, and that connects to a modem that has a cell phone signal, and that lets us know if there's any abnormal heart rhythms. You're also able to activate it and record signals from that as well. The Holter monitor is continuously recording. It covers every single beat. Some people have symptoms that come and go, not just within 48 hours. And for those people, we often send them home with a 30-day event monitor. That is similar to a Holter. It connects with the electrodes, but it typically has less. In this case, it's just two, and it also connects to a modem that can transmit. It is monitored by EKG technicians, and if they see something abnormal, they will call us oftentimes in the middle of the night. Some people don't like the wires that the Holter or the event monitor have. They can get in the way sometimes. So one company came out with what's called the Zio patch. This is basically a sticker that sits on the chest wall, and basically they mail it to you. You place it, wear it for 2 weeks, and then mail it back. During that time, you are not monitored by an EKG technician. So you mail it back, then they review it for results. But patients do like this quite a bit because it is pretty convenient to wear. For prolonged monitoring, we have also placed what's called implantable loop recorders. This is an example of it. It's a cardiac device. It's something metal. It's placed by making a nick in the skin and then placing this over the chest where the heart sits. And this records the EKGs of the heart, and it has enough battery for 3 years. It also communicates to a transponder, so it emails us once a month with information about your heart. Also, if it finds any abnormal or dangerous rhythms, it'll email us sooner. For some people, what I recommend is what's called the AliveCor. If someone is symptomatic, what they can do is they can measure their EKG themselves. This company sells this little product here that pairs with your smartphone. You put your two fingers on it, and it connects to your smartphone, and it can record it. And then you can look at it with your doctor. They recently came out with a newer version of it that has six different leads, and the quality is actually excellent. Apple also has integrated an EKG into their watch. So a lot of my patients have the Apple Watch. That is always looking at your heart rate, but is only recording your EKG if you push your finger to the bezel. The quality has been better than you might expect. The quality is actually quite good for that. And the nice thing about the Apple Watch is that you always have it on, or most people have it on most of the time. So you can always just touch your bezel if you want to record an EKG. As far as which monitor is right for you, the factors that you and your doctor will talk about are if you're symptomatic or not, if your symptoms are frequent or not. Based on how often you're getting symptoms, we'll try to tailor it based on the certain monitoring. Whether you need to be monitored while wearing it, whether you need an EKG technologist to be aware of your heart rhythm while wearing it, and then finally, patient preference. So I hope this helps. If you have any questions, give us a call or leave us a message. Thank you so much.